Hello, everyone. Hello. I hope you're all as excited as I am for this event. I mean, it's nice to know that there are other activities to do here besides partying. Not that I have anything against partying, but it's just like when you do it all the time, it just gets old. So my name is Eiad Alhamed. I am from Syria originally, and I study marketing here at EMU. I'm a senior year. I've been a part of the Middle East Partnership Initiative, the Student Leaders Program, which is a leadership program held in the United States of America, basically where all the students from all over the Middle East gather and do leadership seminars. So I'm going to talk to you about how to get behind the wheel. And I know you're probably wondering now when you hear these words, get behind the wheel, probably expecting a leadership lecture. But no, I'm not going to give you any lecture. Actually, I'm going to tell you a story. This story had happened to me years ago. I grew up and I was raised in Saudi Arabia. So basically, each summer, I would go to Syria, see my family, see my friends, have some fun. One of these years, I was really in a hurry, so I took the bus and I just went over there, which is a 36-hour ride, but it was fine. It was fine until I got to the borders. That's when I decided it was a good idea to get down and have a meal. It wasn't such a good idea when I came back and the bus was gone. And it left me on the borders all alone, and I had left my passport and I left my stuff all in the bus. So after a few hours of explaining my situation to the police, they actually let me go, and I had to take a ride with a random car. And the driver was really surprised. He was an old man. He asked me, "What happened to you?" And after I told him the story, he looked at me in shock. Like, how could you let this happen to you? I said, "It's not my fault. The bus had left me." And he looked at me. He said, "Well, you left your stuff in the bus. You left your passport in the bus. It's definitely your fault." I said, "This is normal. This is what I would do all the time. This is what anybody would do." He said, "Exactly. This is what anybody would do. You don't want to be like anybody else. You know what your problem is, kid? You're sleepwalking." And when he said that to me, it kind of hit me inside. But I was young. I didn't really pay attention until a while later. I started thinking, what does that old man mean? What I'm trying to say here is that most of us go through life thinking that the things that happen to us are beyond our control. We either say it's bad luck or we say it's not my fault. We hear this a lot, it's not my fault. Let me tell you something, we all have computers these days. We have accounts, we have passwords that are protecting our accounts, and only we can access our accounts because only we know the password, except for hackers. You see, hackers, they can access information whenever they want simply because they know how to program. They know how to develop. They have the skill of programming. So this is what separates us from them. It's just the skill. So what if I tell you that life works the same way? You can basically hack life. You can get to achieve whatever it is that you want if you have the necessary skill to do it. Well, I'm going to tell you something. Let me imagine and let you all imagine someone who's really negative, someone who's really blaming everything that happens to him on other people, on other events. And at the same time, I want you all to imagine someone who is the exact opposite, someone who's very positive, someone who can turn the events around him and get the best outcome possible. Did you ever stop and think what makes the difference between these people? What makes all the difference between someone who's very outgoing, who's someone who's very, very active, someone who can achieve what they want, and someone who's just sitting around the corner asking themselves, why is this happening to me? Well, it's their perspective about life. It's how they perceive themselves. It's the programs inside their heads. We all program ourselves every day, and we do it subconsciously. We don't know that we're doing it to us. We all know that we have a conscious level of mind and the subconscious. And the conscious level, it's like the smart guy. It's the logical. It's the skeptical. It's the one that we don't like to use most of the time. But on the back of our heads, we have the subconscious, which is basically the level of the mind that actually executes the stuff that we've learned automatically. So let me give you an example. Remember when we first started to count to 10 when we were kids? At first, we did it consciously, slowly, and then it became a habit. But here's the twist. What if you learned to count to 10 in the wrong way? What if your teacher, let's say, taught you to count like 1, 2, 3, 5, 7? You as a kid, you will learn this, and it's gonna be normal to you, and you're gonna keep doing it forever. Because your subconscious is not designed to check whether what you've learned is correct or not. It's only designed to execute what you've learned automatically. Now, why am I saying all of this? Because I want you to think. I want you to think about your life. What if you've learned the wrong lessons from your experiences? In what area in your life do you think you're counting to 10 in the wrong way? Doesn't that answer the question to why some people can achieve their goals easily while others spend their entire lives getting nowhere? What if you're sleepwalking? So you should be able to observe yourself, observe your reactions, and ask yourself, is my behavior serving me? Is it helping me getting where I want in life? Take control of your actions. Switch off the autopilot and get behind the wheel. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.